The king of the north will play up to those who betray the holy covenant. How do you betray the holy covenant? By doing negative things. You are supposed to pay your tithe. You don't pay your tithe. You don't engage in kingdom investment. You don't engage in sacrificial giving. When God increases your salary, your income, you don't increase your giving. You are working against the covenants. And when you do that, the Bible said the king of the north will play up to those who betray the holy covenant, corrupting them, even with, you know, correcting them even further with his seductive talk, telling you it does not matter. Nobody knows. Just do it by yourself. But those who stay courageously loyal to their God will take a strong stand. Those who will be representatives of God's purpose on earth are not just those who know God, but they are those who are being transformed by knowing God. If you are going to represent God in this time, you are going to be transformed. 2 Corinthians 3:18. It said, as we look into the glass constantly, daily, correctly, the Bible said we have been transformed into his image. We have been transformed. Your transformation only affects you. It is the effect of that transformation that helps you to create values that blesses people. So, you can't say, oh, I've been transformed. You have been transformed, but you are not creating values. And as long as you are not creating values, there is no way you'll be rewarded, because your reward is not your transformation. Your reward is in your creative values. What the transformation has done in you that you were able to put into work is what become a blessing to people. And when your values begin to affect people, they'll begin to bless you. So don't envy people that have been blessed by people. The reason they bless them is because they are creating values that are touching their lives. You will keep complaining, I don't have money, because you are waiting for money to fall. Money don't come to people because they need it. Money goes to people because they created value. Now your value is proof that you have been transformed. After you have been transformed is what determines if you'll be blessed or you'll not be blessed. A lot of people have been gifted. They've been gifted, but along the line, they start falling short. When you give position to somebody who is not due for it, it will abuse it. Instead of it working harder, it will see it as a privilege. You gave him a big name. You are now the manager of this company. He was very faithful, but immediately you upgraded and gave him a title. He said, became big. He's not a big boy. He will no longer be committed to what he's doing. When you ask him, he will have one flimsy excuse or the other. You know what? The position is killing him. He's not qualified for it. If we can be sincere with ourselves, look at around us today. There are people that were very faithful and committed, loyal. Immediately they were upgraded to position. When you are looking for them, they stroll into church when they like. You don't choose by sight, you choose by leading. That is how it is. Oh, you are not the head of this group. And you know you don't have the capacity for it. But it has been slammed on you. It kills you. Why not resign from that position and just be yourself? Because you will never be blessed in that position. Because you will struggle, because the load is too heavy for your head. And the neck is pressed. May God deliver us from error. Your transformation bless you alone. Only your values blesses others. This is when your life starts to be rewarded, when you are valuable. So instead of you complaining, create values. Instead instead of you reacting, create values. People will naturally respect you when they discover that you are imparting them. If you know what I'm teaching you now, you will not be offended again. You will never be offended again. I used to be like that. I used to be very, very reactive. When people don't know, they don't do what I expect them to do, I react. But these days, I'll just be watching you. If you are not doing, I look for somebody else to do a replacement for you immediately, or I will do it myself. By so doing, I won't be offending you, I will be offending myself. What I'm after is getting the job done. So, value gives you rest. Value empowers you. Value makes you confident. Value uplifts and connects you. Come on, say, I hear. Don't forget this. Your similarity decides your comfort. If you do what every other person does, you'll be comfortable. But your differences is what decides your rewards in life. Similarity brings comfort. Your differences brings reward. If somebody that can do it better than you shows up, your value will be deteriorating. Nobody values you anymore. So what do? Create value. Be valuable. When you understand what I'm teaching you now, you will not want your seat to be vacant. If you understand what I'm telling you now, you want to seek to remain there by upgrading and building yourself. No man can pay you. Only rewards make you satisfied. Write it down. It will help you. Salary does not pay you. It is reward that makes you balance. When you are rewarded, oh, you have been faithful. I've watched you over the time. Wow. I want to reward you. Rewards don't come always. It seldomly comes. And when reward shows up, when you are paid the price, it changed 10 years toiling. Do you understand what I'm teaching now? So reward is very, very important. When you are in the midst of people who are doing the same thing, you become very, very comfortable. Creating the systems of accommodation. That's what you are doing. You are being accommodated. Doing the same thing. Everybody's, all of us, what did you score? 40. What did you score? 39. What did you score? 42. What did you score? 45. What did you score? Everybody 40, 40, 40. He said, this man a wicked man. Nobody will feel bad. When you see you score 40, you ask this. What did you score? 60. 75. 90. 92. Nobody will tell you to go and read. If you wanted to buy snacks to eat in school, you will lose appetite. So when you do what others do, you become comfortable. When you stay around people that do the same thing with you, you are creating a system of accommodation. But the day you choose to do things differently, wow, you pull out. You pull out. So your ability to realize, to be different, to start creating value is what determines your next level. In business, in ministry, in your career, in politics, in everything you want to do. Just be different. Nobody celebrates common things. People want to go for what is rare. Everybody wants to go for what is rare. Work on yourself and be different. Those are extremely valuables are the ones that will command influence into this world. Those people who are extremely valuable. Look at yourself. What are you doing that people are interested in? How long do you want to stay in the place that you are in? Until you tell yourself the truth, you are not ready for advancement. Tell yourself the truth. Evaluate yourself. Don't let people evaluate you. When people evaluate you, because you are a human, chances are, because you are not exposed, you react. Why is he telling me I'm not doing it? The ones I've been doing, has he ever told me you are doing well? You know, such people can never be helped. They need to get to a point in their life when they are stopped. They begin to ask themselves, why am I here? Why am I at this level? That's when life opens up for you. I have a philosophy in my life. If you tell me what I'm doing is wrong, I will appreciate it. I'll go and work on myself. Because anybody who tells you you are making mistake, they actually love your advancement. But when nobody tells you what you are doing is wrong, my dear, your future is bleak. And people run from people that tell them the truth. They go to people that tell them lies. Isaiah 60, verse 3, New King James Version. Look at what the Bible says about the light. The Gentiles shall come to your light. Common people, Gentiles. People that will appreciate you, give you audience, will come to your light. And kings to the brightness of your rising. So, if you want to be more valued, create quality value. The quality people will begin to pull to you. Spend time to develop yourself. Spend time. Roaming up and down does not increase your productivity. It only makes you ordinary. He said, the Gentiles, the common people, people will come to your light. Everybody wants to identify with something. But great people don't rush. They watch with keen interest over time.